people evacuated from Sudan by the UK arrived at Larnaca International Airport in Cyprus today as the UK continues a military operation to evacuate its citizens. The UK government said it has so far evacuated more than 300 British and other foreign nationals from the violence after it began civilian airlifts on Tuesday. People are seen disembarking from an RAF plane in Cyprus following their evacuation from Sudan, where 4,000 dual nationality Britons and 400 UK only passport holders remain, according to the British government. A total of 8 evacuation flights have so far left Khartoum. Documentation checks on those on board were carried out in Cyprus before the onward journey to the UK. More than 2,000 British citizens are registered in Sudan with the Foreign Office. Also, a ship carrying 1,687 civilians from more than 50 countries fleeing violence in Sudan docked in Saudi Arabia, the largest evacuation effort by the Gulf Kingdom so far, according to the Foreign Ministry. Saudi Arabia has received several rounds of evacuees by air and sea since fighting broke out in Africa's third biggest country on April 15th, part of what analysts describe as an effort to position itself as a major player in responding to regional crises. The group that arrived in the coastal city of Jeddah from Port Sudan, on transported by one of the kingdom's ships, and the kingdom was keen to provide all the basic needs of foreign nationals in preparation for their departure.
We left our home, our belongings. We left our country, Syria, because of the war, and we came to another country, Sudan, which is also facing war. This experience, which we have lived twice, was very difficult for us, especially since it's not the first time. The situation over there is very difficult, but thank God.
Sudan.
I didn't spend a lot of time in Sudan, but we are very close to it. Its people are very kind and don't deserve what's happening with them. Sudan is a country where we spent 16 years of our life. It means a lot to us, and we have lived a long period of time there. We left our houses, all our belongings, so for sure we feel as if we are in a nightmare.
The fighting in Sudan pits from forces loyal to Army Chief Abdel Fattah al-Burhan against those backing his deputy who turned rival, who commands the powerful paramilitary rapid support forces. At least 459 people have been killed and more than 4,000 wounded, according to UN agencies.